Hare Krishna, dear devotees, and welcome to today's session. How are you doing? I pray that all is well with you and your families at this time. How is the Purushotam Maas challenge going? We are very excited to see so many devotees are interested in taking on the challenge. And today we're on day number 5. So we're moving on with the Purushotam Maas Bhagavad Gita reading. And today we are reading verses 3 and 4, which is combined, and it's a huge lot of text, so we're just reading through the translation, and it goes as follows. The real form of this tree cannot be perceived in this world. No one can understand where it ends, where it begins, or where its foundation is. But with determination, one must cut down the strongly rooted tree with the weapon of detachment. Thereafter, one must seek that place from which, having gone, one never returns, and then surrender to that Supreme Personality of Godhead, from whom everything began and from whom everything has extended since time immemorial. So that's the translation. Let's go through each part of it. So Prabhupada starts again by saying, the real form of this tree cannot be perceived in this world. So you remember we were talking about this banyan tree and it's all its branches going upward and downward. We can't figure it out. It's such a maze entanglement. But this aspirant, Vedavit, the one who's trying to know what's going on here and trying to achieve a liberation from the situation, he is endeavoring. So the real tree, the problem that he's having is that he is focusing on the reflection. Now, you know, in reality, if you're focusing on the reflection, you can't be looking at the real tree. You're either looking at the reflection in the water or you're looking at the real tree. But he doesn't know what the real tree is. He's looking at the reflection. He doesn't know that the real tree is Krishna and the spiritual world. He's looking at the reflection, which is this material existence. And from this, he's trying to figure his way out to get up to the spiritual world. So, but how is he doing it? By looking at the reflection, and he's trying to adjust the reflection. He's trying to, like what it's described in this tree, to cut down the tree by knowledge. We were reading that yesterday. So how do you cut down something that's in a reflection? It doesn't exist. It's not real. So each time you endeavor, it becomes futile. You're grabbing at the water. It doesn't affect the reflection in any. You're not catching any substance, it's just shadow. That's why your efforts are futile. So this aspirant is going on trying to endeavor at this unreal image. An image is unreal, it's a reflection. But the real form of the tree actually exists. But he has no idea of that. But this is what he's supposed to focus on. If he focuses on that, then that's the better, higher principle. Then he can achieve what he wants. Prabhupada goes on to say, no one can understand where it ends, where it begins, or where the foundation is. But with determination, one must cut down the strongly rooted tree with the weapon of detachment. So I'm just remembering also in the 11th chapter, Arjuna was describing Krishna's universal form like this. And Krishna's universal form is this material existence. So he was describing this image that it's so vast, there's no end. In all directions I'm seeing you, Krishna. I don't even know which way to offer obeisances. Arjuna was so bold. So we're seeing the same kind of idea here, that it's so vast, it's so huge. But how can one break through this? By determination and detachment. So the process going up, there's two processes. One is going up by your own effort, and the other one is the mercy of Krishna. So the effort going up, your own effort, that is through being determined. I'm just going to do it. I'm just going to do it. Being determined and being detached. Now we know determination on its own doesn't last long. It's sometimes it's born out of the mode of passion, and therefore it won't last long. You need actually a higher taste. Param drishtam nivartate vishaya vinivartante nirharaschaya dehinam rasoparsya rasovarja param drishtam nivartate. That you need the higher taste. If you don't get the taste, just by determination, you're not going to make it. You need something, some spiritual experience or taste to keep you connected to that spiritual platform. Because just by determination, nobody is going to achieve it. And then Prabhupada, the verse describes detachment, by being detached. Now that's a good thing. But just being detached without replacing it with anything, then what happens? You then gradually get pulled back because you have to param dvistam nivartate, replace it with a higher taste. If you take out something, you must replace it with something. It can't be a vacuum. So what this aspirant is doing is just by determination, I'm going to do it. That's one part, and then he's detaching from the world. So usually brahmacharis start that way. Determination and detachment. No talking to Matajis and no eating this and that and that. So you start that way. But after a couple of years, hey, what happened to that Prabhu? So this is the process on your own effort. But if you get the higher taste by the association of devotees, then you get Krishna's mercy. And by getting that, then anything is possible. So two parts we're seeing here. One is that the aspirant is endeavoring on his own effort with detachment and determination. And the other part is where the Supreme Lord is giving mercy through his devotees' association, getting the higher taste. And then once you get Krishna's mercy that way, then naturally, Vasudeva Bhagavati Bhakti Yoga Prayojita Janeti Asyu Vairagyam Jnanam Chayat Ahoitakam. So 1.2.7 Srimad Bhagavatam, this verse comes. That for one who gets the mercy of the Supreme Lord, then naturally Janeti Asyu Vairagyam, knowledge comes and detachment comes. Naturally, one who is practicing bhakti. So let's see what Prabhupada says here. Thereafter, so having now achieved that detachment level and determination now, remember we're going up the path of jnana at the moment in this section. So he's going up on his own effort, not the mercy. Bhakti is the mercy of Krishna. Jnana is on your own effort. So on his own effort, what happens? So moving up, he then, with determination and detachment, is trying to reach the spiritual platform. When he attains it, that platform will be the Brahman platform. And we know at the end of the 14.27, Krishna says, Brahmano hi pratishtaham. I am the foundation of this Brahman. So once you know that, then why try to endeavor for that when it has a foundation, which is Krishna? Better endeavor for Krishna. How do you endeavor for Krishna? By bhakti, not by jnana. So once you read, but now we're going through the jnana path because this is what the aspirant is doing, the person who's endeavoring. So once he achieves that Brahman level, now what do you do after that? So there, this verse is saying, thereafter one must seek that place from which, having gone, one never returns. And then, so you must seek that place. Then it's actually a place. It's a geological position, but it's a spiritual one. So having reached that platform, then what he must do? So he's endeavored with detachment and determination. He's come to the place. And now what he must do after that? Prabhupada goes on to say, and there surrender to that Supreme Personality of Godhead, from whom everything began and from whom everything has extended since time immemorial. So after having gone all of that, found the place, then you must surrender to Krishna, the Supreme Being. And then from whom time immemorial has been worshipped there. So the bhakti path is giving the same thing, which is easier now. You have to go this way, detachment. That's why the jnanis are so great ascetics and great sannyasis. They're very determined and they're very detached. But that creates hardness in the heart. And then they get to the spiritual world, the Brahman platform, and then they've achieved that level. And then what? And then they still now have to go to surrender to the Supreme Person. Are Baba, Bhakti Yoga was saying that in the first place only, na? Bhakti was saying that in the first place, just surrender to the person, Purushottam, Krishna. And then you don't have to go through all the struggle. So you can see one path is your own effort going up. The other path is the devotional path with Krishna and achieving the same goal, which is easier also. So why do you want to go through all this entanglement, upside down tree? Your whole mind and life is all upside down after that. You want to go through that whole thing and then come to the same path? Are, take Mahaprasad, chant Hare Krishna, go back to Godhead, Baba. Don't go through all this difficult path. Bhakti, simple, easier, best process. Prabhupada goes on to say, purport, it is now clearly stated that the real form of this banyan tree cannot be understood in this material world. Yes, how can you understand the real form when you're looking at the reflection? You're observing the reflection, trees, branches, this object of the senses, oof, too much. But where you're looking? You're looking at the reflection. If you're looking at the reflection, you're missing the real thing. You can't look at both. You got to look at either a reflection or the real thing. Since the root is upwards, the extension of the real tree is at the other end. So it's on the other side. You're looking at the reflection, you want to get the real image. How is that possible? Not possible. Prabhupada goes on to say, when entangled with the material expansions of the tree, one cannot see how far the tree extends, nor can one see the beginning of this tree. Yet one has to find out the cause. So when you entangle with this, you're trying to look, you can't even see where it started. Like we see here, where is the beginning of this tree? Look at how this maze is. This is just a big entangled forest, but actually it's one tree. And if I had to ask you, where is the beginning of this tree? How would you know? Where is the first root structure that was planted here? You'll never know. You'll never know because it's all just mixed up. So Prabhupada goes on to say, I am the son of my father. My father is the son of such and such and such a person, etc. Unquote. By searching in this way, one comes to Brahma. So he's saying Prabhupada would use this technique of trying to understand God without, by logic and without any evidence or, you know, without any empiric scientific method. So Prabhupada says it's very logical. You just look, you have a father and then he has a father, he has a father, he has a father, he has a father. And you keep going back till you come to the cause of all causes where there's no other father after that. When you come to that point, then you know. Janmadiyasya yataha, first verse Bhagavatam, from him whom everything is born, that is Krishna. So you keep going, going, you'll come to Brahma. Then from Brahma, you'll see, no, he has a cause. He has a cause, is Mahavishnu. From there, Mahavishnu, you keep going. And then you'll see, Janmadiyasya yataha, from him whom everything is born, the source of creation, that then is Krishna. So by logic, you can even go that way. Otherwise, how are you existing here? The fact that you existing means there's a whole line ahead of you. Your own parampara line. So Prabhupada goes on. Who is generated by the Garbhadakshaya Vishnu? Finally, in this way, when one reaches the Supreme Personality of Godhead, That is the end of research work. So that's the same example I gave you now. So Prabhupada goes on to say, one has to search out that origin of this tree, the Supreme Personality of Godhead, through the association of persons who are in knowledge of that Supreme Personality of Godhead. So how do you search it out? Not by detachment and determination, by asking someone who knows, by association. And that association is the devotees. By associating with the devotees, they will tell you, Bahunam janmane ante jnanavam mam prapadyante vasudeva sarvamiti sa mahatma sudullabha. That after endeavoring for many years of perfection, even lifetime, some may even attain it. But of those who've attained it, hardly one knows me in truth. Vasudev sarvamiti. Hardly one knows who is Vasudev. But the devotee, he knows. Bhakti mam abhijnati yavanyas chasma tattvataha tato mam tattvato gyatva vishanam tattanantaram. Arjun, this path of bhakti, bhakti mam abhijnati, only this path can know me. Only this path. The other paths of karma, jnana, and astanga, no. But bhakti, ha, bhakti mam abhijnati. By bhakti I can be understood. As I am in full, standing here before you, he tells Arjun. So Prabhupada goes on to say, then by understanding one becomes gradually detached from this false reflection of reality. See, because you're looking at the false reality and you're expecting to change that and expecting that to be the outcome. No, we have to look at the true reality, which is the tree itself, not the reflection. Prabhupada goes on to say, and by knowledge one can cut off the connection and actually become situated in the real tree. Jnana iti ashu vairagyam, that you by knowledge and detachment, one that naturally comes through bhakti. You don't have to endeavor for it like the way this person is doing. Prabhupada goes on to say, the word asanga, yes, detachment. This word asanga means detachment. So we see in the 13th chapter, verse 22, we also see this verse comes there. Purusha prakriti stohi bhunte prakriti janguna karuna guna sangasya satta satyoni janmeshu. So karana guna sangasya, by associating with the modes of nature, one becomes contaminated. So one has to associate with bhakti. So this asanga also comes in today's verse, this by detaching from the modes and engaging, by detaching from the three modes of nature and engaging in bhakti yoga, devotion, then one can easily transcend. So Prabhupada goes on to say, the word asanga is very important in this connection because the attachment for sense enjoyment and lording it over the material nature is very strong. Therefore, one must learn to detach by discussion of spiritual science based on authoritative scriptures, and one must hear from persons who are actually in knowledge. So look at what Prabhupada's remedy is. You detach by hearing from devotees about Krishna. You don't detach by determination. You detach by hearing about Krishna from devotees. As a result of such discussion in the association of devotees, again Prabhupada is saying, you discuss in association of devotees. What is the result? One comes to the Supreme Personality of Godhead. See, the result is that you get Krishna, and our aspirant poor fellow, he's also trying and getting the same thing, but coming through the long cut. Here we're taking shortcut. So Prabhupada goes on to say, then the first thing one must do is surrender unto him. So once you reach the spiritual world, the first thing you do is surrender to Krishna. Purushottama, we see that. Like in religions like Islam, where Allahu Akbar, Allah, God is the greatest. They are very absorbed in the power of God, the majesty of God, in all His opulences.
that they say God is the greatest, Allahu Akbar. And we see also in Christianity, if you want to ever contest the philosophy of Christianity, it's said in the Bible that the heavens and earth was created in 7 days. So if heaven and earth was created, that means heaven was also created, then where was God standing when he created the heaven? Where was he standing? He was in a different place. And that's this place that we're talking about. Yatgattvam nanivartante tat dhamam paramam mama. This abode of mine, Arjun. This, when you come there, you don't come back. So all the sincere, our Christian brothers who are endeavoring to go to heaven, that's not God's permanent residence. He's not even there. Because he is where he was standing when he created heaven. Where was he standing? That's his permanent residence. So think carefully if you want to go to heaven or you want to go to the spiritual world. We as devotees, we want to go to where God is, to the spiritual world. Prabhupada goes on to say, the description of that place, whence having gone, one never returns to this false reflected tree, is given here. So it's a big difference between that place and this false reflected place that we're in. So that is permanent, this is a reflection. Prabhupada goes on to say, the Supreme Personality of Godhead, Krishna, is the original root from whom everything has emanated. To gain favor of that personality of Godhead, one has only to surrender. And this is a result of performing devotional service by hearing, chanting, etc. So Prabhupada is saying, this is how you get to Krishna. And that is how you get to Krishna in the Jnani way. So which is easier? Here you just have to hear and chant. Their detachment and determination and all that. Hey, who is going to manage that? Prabhupada goes on to say, he is the cause of the extension of the material world. This has already been explained by the Lord himself. Aham sarvasya prabhavo 10.8. So this is the Chatur Sloki Gita. Aham sarvasya prabhavo matta sarvam prabhatyate iti matva bhajante maam buddha bhava samanvitaha. So Krishna is saying that I am the source of everything material and spiritual. And everything emanates from me, just like, and everything is strung on me, just like pearls are strung on a thread. So Prabhupada is quoting this verse and he says, I am the origin of everything. Therefore, to get out of this entanglement of the strong banyan tree of material life, one must surrender to Krishna. As soon as one surrenders unto Krishna, one becomes detached automatically from this material extension. So I think it's very self-evident what we were discussing today. Bhakti is the easier path. So I hope you enjoyed today's class and I hope it's making a little more sense to you, all this entanglement. And we'll join you tomorrow. Hare Krishna!